And then I'm going to ask Brother Abraham to please come up here. We want to welcome everyone. Queremos darle la bienvenida a todos a Freedom in Truth Church, a la Iglesia Libertad en la Verdad. We welcome to Freedom in Truth Church. And most of you know that we do two languages in here. So we most of what we say or sing is going to be English and Spanish. So just bear with us. And I'm so glad that you decide on this day to join us. Also keep in mind, we are recording the service, and we will upload it to YouTube within 24 hours of the recording day. Amen. Brother Abraham will read in Spanish, and Sister Shanda, his lovely wife, will be reading in English.
God bless you, everyone. Can you please stand for the reading of the scriptures? Today we will be reading from Psalms 32. Again, I will be reading in English and Brother Abraham in Spanish. Blessed is the one whose transgressions are forgiven, whose sins are covered.
Bienaventurado aquel cuya transgresión ha sido perdonada y cubierto su pecado.
Blessed is the one whose sin the Lord does not count against them, and whose spirit is no deceit.
Bienaventurado el hombre a quien Jehová no culpa de iniquidad, y en suyo espíritu no hay engaño.
Verse 3, when I kept silent, my bones wasted away through my groaning all day long.
Mientras callé, se envejecieron mis huesos en mi gemir todo el día.
For day and night, your hand was heavy on me. My strength was sapped as in the heat of summer.
Porque de día y de noche tu mano fue pasada sobre mí. Mis fuerzas estaban debilitadas como en el color del verano.
Verse 5. Then I acknowledged my sin to you and did not cover up my iniquity. I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord, and you forgave the guilt of my sin.
Entonces os confesé mi pecado y no encubrí mi iniquidad. Dije, confesaré mis transgresiones al Señor, y tú perdonaste la culpa de mi pecado.
Therefore, let all the faithful pray to you while you may be found. Surely the rising of the mighty waters will not reach them.
Por tanto, oren a ti todos los fieles mientras puede ser hallado. Seguramente la crecida de las impetuosas aguas no los alcanzará.
Verse 7. You are my hiding place. You will protect me from the trouble and surround me with songs of deliverance.
Tú eres mi escondite. Me protegerás de la angustia y me rodearás de cánticos de liberación.
I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my loving eye on you.
Yo os instruí y os enseñaré el camino que debéis andar. Te aconsejaré con mi mirada amorosa sobre ti.
Verse 9. Do not be like the horse or the mule, which have no understanding, but must be controlled by bit and bridle, or they will not come to you.
No seáis como el caballo o el mulo, que no tienen entendimiento, sino que deben ser controlados con freno y freno, para que no vengan a vosotros.
Many are the woes of the wicked, but the Lord's unfailing love surrounds the one who trusts in him.
Muchas son las aflicciones de los impios, pero el amor inagotable del Señor envuelve al que en él confía.
Verse 11. Rejoice in the Lord and be glad, you righteous, sing all you who are upright in heart.
Alegraos en el Señor y alegraos vosotros, sois justos. Canta todos los rectos de corazón. All right, everybody, bow your heads. We're going to pray. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for yet again another opportunity to be amongst believers, amongst those who care for each other, who love each other. Lord, I pray you give us peace, understanding. You open our hearts to hear what you got to say today. Share and give us some of your wisdom. Give us some of your insight into the knowledge of the world, knowledge of things that's going on. And most of all, give us the strength, Lord, to be able to bear our cross and bear these hard times. Whether it's good times or bad times, we know all of them come from you. We thank you for the good times because it's a blessing. We thank you for the bad times because in those times, you strengthen our hearts, you strengthen our minds, and you strengthen our backs to continue to fight for others and for ourselves and for your cause. In the name of Jesus Christ, I thank you very much. Amen, amen, and amen.
Amen.
Now we will have worship by Brother Dan.
Our God. As long as I am.
Amen. How many of you know that God is truly, truly able? ¿Cuántos de ustedes saben que Dios, de veras, de veras, Él puede todo? If it's somebody that can do something, it is my God. Now I want you to say, it is my God. Say it with me. It is my God. It is my God who is able. I might not be able to do it, but God can do it. The most impossible things. You know why? Because He has done it. Just the fact that you're here is a miracle. Just the fact that you're here today on a Sunday when you could have been in the beautiful park right now or watching a movie at home. No, it's a miracle that you're here today. And the miracle was done by a miracle worker. So because we know that God is able, we're going to give Him praise. And we're going to give it to Him good because He can do it. Hallelujah. And it's only one of the three answers you're going to get. You're either going to get yes, you're either going to get no, or you're going to get later. But God always answers. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, I want to thank the Lord for Brother Dan. Thank you so much, Brother Dan, for coming and rejoicing with us today. We want to worship the Lord, the living God, together. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to ask for Brother Abraham to please come up here, and he's going to be able to come and pick up tithes and offerings. El hermano Abraham va a venir a recoger los diezmos y las ofrendas. And I will ask Brother Dan if you can sing one last song. Amen. As we pick up tithes and offerings. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. So I have a Bible scripture for the offering, Sister Raven, if you can put it up there. So on the screen, we're going to read this scripture. Amen. And en la pantalla vamos a leer esta escritura. As Brother Abraham come up here. So the scripture says, Sister Raven, if you can go to the next slide. So in English says, give and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your lap. For with the measure you use it, it will be measured back to you. Dice la palabra de Dios en español, dad y se os dará, se pondrá en vuestro regazo una medida buena, apretada, remecida y rebosante, porque con la medida que uséis os serás medido. Lord Jesus, we want to thank you, Lord God. Lord God, in this basket, Lord God, as we place our offering, as we place, Lord God, our trust in you with our finances, Lord God. God, if I can trust you with my life, why can't I trust you with my finances, Lord God? Yes, the finances is close to my heart, Lord God. And many times, I don't think I can do it, but it is only through you. Because you're able, you help me to make the week. Because you're able, you help me to make the month. Lord God, without you, we are absolutely nothing. Lord, allow me not just to put my trust and my offerings in this basket, but allow me to put myself as a living sacrifice, as an offering to you. And let that measure be just the Bible scripture says, in Jesus' mighty name, Lord God, multiply it according to your number, not my number, according to the need that is met, Lord God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Hallelujah. And the church of God says, amen.
Thank you.
us. For every minute of worship is a worth it minute. Can you say that?
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to ask Sister Shonda to please come up here. We're going to go ahead and give the announcements. You may be seated. And please find the best seat, because today's message is an explosive one. It's an amazing message. Amen. So thank you, Jesus. Find yourself the best seat in the room. Amen. Again, Brother Dan, thank you so much. And how many of you would like to see Brother Dan again soon? Amen. Thank you, Lord.
God bless you, everyone. So the following are going to be some announcements and a few reminders.
Estos van a ser ciertos recordatorios y van algunas anuncios.
We have Wednesday prayer starting at 7:30.
El miércoles los invitamos a las 7:30.
Friday Bible study at 7:30.
El viernes estudio bíblico a las 7:30.
We want to thank the Fit Men's Ministry providing the meal last Sunday.
Queremos agradecer a todos los varones porque ellos trajeron la comida del domingo pasado. Amen. Let's give a hand clap to them. Amen.
Today's meal is donated by Sister Ayler. She's our newest member.
Nuestra hermana Ayler, ella trajo toda la comida para compartir con nosotros. Muchas gracias, hermana Ayler.
Thanks to everyone who attended the church the day of the eclipse, which was April 8th.
Gracias a todos los hermanos que pudieron asistir a un servicio de oración aquí el día lunes 8 de abril, el día del eclipse.
Another thank you to all those who came out on yesterday, April 13th, to help clean the church.
Muchas gracias también a todos los que pudieron venir el día de ayer a limpiar la iglesia con nosotros.
Everything that you do, small or big, does not go unnoticed, so we thank you for everything that you do in the church.
Muchas gracias por todo lo que hacen o por todo lo que traen a la iglesia. No se ignora y podemos ver todo lo que usted hace. Muchas gracias.
The Fit Women's Ministry meeting is next Saturday. That's April 20th at 12 p.m.
El próximo sábado a las 12 p.m. es la reunión de las damas.
We invite all the ladies to come out and attend.
Invitamos a todas las hermanas, por favor, vengan a asistir.
Don't forget the church is doing a fasting and the sign-up sheet is in the back on the bulletin.
Y acuérdense que la iglesia está también ayunando. El boletín de ayuno está ahí atrás para que usted anote su nombre.
Baptism classes will be Monday the 15th, Tuesday the 16th, and Thursday the 18th at 7 p.m.
Las clases de bautismo comienzan esta próxima semana y va a ser el lunes 15, el martes 16 y el jueves 18.
The church usually celebrates birthdays at the end of the month, but today we will be celebrating a special birthday.
La iglesia usualmente celebra los cumpleaños al final del mes, pero el día de hoy estaremos celebrando un cumpleaños especial.
Our 6-hour spiritual retreat of this month will be Friday, April 26th, from 7:30 p.m. to 1:30 a.m.
Nuestra vigilia de retiro espiritual va a ser el día 26, es de 6 horas, de 7:30 a la 1:30 de la mañana.
Thank you. This concludes the announcement.
Muchísimas gracias. Esto concluye los anuncios. And I'm going to ask Pastor Calvin to please come up here. Voy a invitar a nuestro Pastor Calvin, por favor, si puede venir por acá. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. And as Pastor Calvin make his way over here, I'm going to ask if you can please stand up to welcome him and to read the Bible together. And if anybody needs a Bible, whether it's in English and Spanish, we do not have Korean or other language. For now, we're starting with English and Spanish. Amen? That was a joke. Hallelujah.
Amen. God bless you all. Y'all ready to hear the word of God today?
Dios los bendiga. ¿Están listos para escuchar la palabra de Dios?
I can't tell. Is there anybody that's ready to hear the word of God today?
Dígame por favor, ¿está listo para escuchar la palabra de Dios? Aleluya.
Thank you again, my brother Dan.
Muchísimas gracias a nuestro hermano Dan.
Also, thank our visitor for being with us today.
Queremos también darle bienvenida
a
nuestro hermano.
God bless you.
Our brother David. Yes. Amen. God bless him and welcome him. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
I'm going to tell all of you right now.
Voy a decirles de una vez.
If you came here today to feed on the Word of God,
si usted vino aquí para alimentarse de la palabra de Dios,
if you came to hear from the Word of God,
si usted vino aquí para escuchar la palabra de Dios,
am I missing something?
You can continue if you can, if you're able to. If not, you can go ahead and close it.
Amen. So,
yeah.
Again, as I was saying,
como decía,
God is going to speak something awesome to you.
Dios va a hablar algo muy especial el día de hoy.
If you came, if you truly came to hear God speak something personally to you,
si usted verdaderamente vino para que Dios le hablara algo secreto de su corazón,
as I was sitting back there in the office praying,
yo estaba sentado allí en la oficina orando,
God was saying, many are going to receive this today because I am speaking to many.
Decía el Señor, muchos van a recibir en este día porque yo voy a hablar con ellos.
So I say to you all right now,
yo les digo a todos de una vez,
pay attention to what the Lord is saying today.
Ponga atención de lo que el Señor está hablando.
He's speaking to you today.
El Señor está hablando en este día.
Now I'm going to share this Bible story with you to just to set us up for this message.
Voy a compartir esta historia de Biblia para comenzar el mensaje.
So we're going to look in our Bibles in the book of Genesis chapter 37.
Si podemos mirar en nuestras Biblias en Génesis
37.
Génesis 37.
I'm going to read verses 1 through 24.
Voy a leer del 1 al 24.
And we're just going to do this part in English because it's so lengthy, Pastor Abby.
El pastor lo va a leer todo en inglés, perdón.
So, all of you that are in your Spanish Bibles, please just read along with me.
Si usted lo tiene en español, por favor, lea junto con nosotros. Amén.
But we're going to set this up for the message today.
Amen.
Amen. So, Genesis chapter 37, verse 1 says, Jacob lived in the land where his father had stayed, the land of Canaan. This is the account of Jacob. Joseph, a young man of 17, was tending the flocks with his brothers, the sons of Bilha and the sons of Zilpha, his father's wives, and he brought their father a bad report about them. Now Israel loved Joseph more than any of his other sons, because he had been born to him in his old age. And he made a richly ornamented robe for him. When his brothers saw that their father loved him more than any of them, they hated him and couldn't even speak a word to him. Joseph had a dream, and when he told it to his brothers, they hated him all the more. He said to them, "Listen to this dream I had. We were binding sheaves of grain out in the field when suddenly my sheaf rose and stood upright while your sheaves gathered around mine and bowed down to it." His brother said to him, "Do you intend to reign over us? Will you actually rule us?" And they hated him all the more because of his dream and what he had said. Then he had another dream, and he told it to his brothers. "Listen," he said, "I had another dream, and this time the sun and moon and 11 stars were bowing down to me." When he told his father, as well as his brothers, his father rebuked him and said, "What is this dream you had? Will your mother and I and your brothers actually come and bow down to the ground before you?" His brothers were jealous of him, but his father kept the matter in mind. Now his brothers had gone to graze their flocks, their father's flocks near Shechem, And Israel said to Joseph, "As you know, your brothers are grazing the flocks near Shechem. Come, and I am going to send you to them." "Very well," he replied. So he said to them, "Go and see if all is well with your brothers and with the flocks, and bring word back to me." Then he sent him off from the valley of Hebron. When Joseph arrived at Shechem, a man found him wandering around the fields and asked him, "What are you looking for?" He replied, "I'm looking for my brothers. Can you tell me where they are grazing?" "They have moved on from here," the man answered, "and I heard them say, 'Let's go to Dothan.'" So Joseph went after his brothers and found them near Dothan. But they saw him in the distance, and before he reached them, they plotted to kill him. "Here comes that dreamer," they said to each other. "Come now, let's kill him and throw him into the pit and say that a furious animal devoured him. Then we'll see what comes of his dreams." When Reuben heard this, he tried to rescue him from their hands. "Let's not take his life," he said. "Don't shed any blood. Throw him into the pit here in the desert, but don't lay a hand on him." Reuben said this to rescue him from them and take him back to his father. So when Joseph came to his brothers, they stripped him of his robe, his richly ornamented robe that he was wearing. And then they took him and threw him into the pit. The pit was empty. There was no water. Let's go ahead and pray for the word.
Amen.
Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you again for blessing us with this day of opportunity, Lord.
Gracias, Señor, por este día, por bendecirnos un día de oportunidad más.
Thank you for this day and this time, Lord God, to be able to come gather together in your name and hear your voice.
Gracias por permitirnos reunirnos, Señor, para escuchar tu voz unidos.
Right now, Lord God, I pray that you will take the distractions from our minds.
En este momento te pedimos que remuevas toda distracción de nuestras mentes.
Take the tiredness from our bodies.
Remuevas todo cansancio de nuestros cuerpos.
Remove any sleepiness from us.
Remuevas toda clase de adormecimiento.
Allow us, Lord God, to be fully alert and be able to consume your word today.
Permítenos, Señor, estar completamente alertos y consumir, comer tu comida espiritual.
Ask that you help myself and Pastor Abby as we deliver this message.
Te pedimos, Señor, que me ayudes a mí y al Pastor Calvin a poder llevar a cabo este mensaje.
As always, Lord God, let it be our lips that move, but your voice that's heard.
Una vez más digo, Señor, deja que tu voz salva por nuestras bocas.
In Jesus' name, all of the people of God said.
En el nombre de Jesús, todos los hijos de Dios dicen.
Amen.
Amen.
So today we're going to be speaking.
El día de hoy estaremos hablando.
With the message title.
Con el título.
A palace praise from the pit.
So en español eso sería una alabanza de palacio desde el foso.
A palace praise from the pit.
Una alabanza de palacio desde el pozo.
So, in this story we just read.
Hermano, en esta historia que acabamos de leer.
Joseph was basically born with a silver spoon in his mouth.
José prácticamente nació con una cuchara de plata en su boca.
He was chosen by God.
Él fue escogido por Dios.
Anointed by God.
Ungido por Dios.
Favored by God.
Favorecido por Dios.
And carried a dream that was given by God.
Y le dieron sueños por Dios.
He was both loved and hated.
Él era los dos cosas. Era amado y era odiado.
Favored and despised.
Él era también favorecido y también rechazado.
Desired and opposed.
Él era deseado y opuesto.
Joseph represents the true believer in Christ.
Hermano José aquí representa el verdadero cristiano.
Regardless of our physical or social economic standard in society.
No importando el tiempo social o económico en la sociedad.
We were born into the kingdom with a silver spoon in our mouth.
Habíamos nacido en el reino con una cuchara de plata en nuestra boca.
like Joseph,
así como José,
we don't have to work for what we have.
No tenemos que trabajar por lo que tenemos.
It's a free gift of grace.
Es una gracia regalada, gratis.
A divine favor.
Por un favor divino.
Everything we have ever needed is already provided for us in Christ.
Todo lo que nosotros necesitamos y necesitemos ya es proveído por Cristo.
Like Joseph.
Así como José.
We're anointed.
Somos ungidos.
We're favored.
Somos favorecidos.
We have a dream.
Tenemos sueño.
A divine God-given destiny.
Tenemos un destino divino dado por Dios.
And like Joseph,
y así como José,
there are adversaries to your anointing.
Hay adversarios. Somebody que pelean tu unción. Alguien va a recibir esto.
Your dream.
Tu sueño.
And your favor,
y tu favor,
have adversaries.
Tiene enemigos, quiero que sepas.
The Bible says that Joseph's brothers,
la Biblia dice que los hermanos de José,
saw the favor over his father, that this, the favor that his father had on him.
Miraron el favor que su padre tenía sobre él.
And his brothers hated him for that.
Sus hermanos lo odiaban por eso.
The Bible says that they hated him more for his dreams.
La Biblia dice que lo odiaban más por sus sueños.
And then the Bible says they hated him even more for his words.
Y la Biblia dice que lo odiaban aún más por sus palabras.
It's a sad fact.
Es un factor triste.
But the greatest